Hello, Dr. Urban here, and I want to talk to you about Alzheimer's and curcumin, turmeric supplements, and turmeric and brain fog issues. Now, I'm enthusiastic about this subject because I take curcumin for an anti-cancer prevention plan of my own. Now, I can't tell you by FDA limitations that I'm preventing or you can prevent cancer, or I can treat conditions, but let's just say that's my plan. That's what I'm doing personally. But when it comes to Alzheimer's and curcumin or turmeric and brain fog, what does this mean? Well, first of all, turmeric is a plant, and that plant contains 1,000 or so known compounds which could have, many of which could have medicinal components. But the main one is curcumin, which is a polyphenol. We know what polyphenols are. And if you take this off your spice rack, you get this yellow compound called turmeric, which is the whole plant ground up, I guess. But the biological or biologically active component is curcumin. So we want to concentrate on that. Well, this curcumin and turmeric, which I'm going to use interchangeably, so just if you would tolerate me in that regard or indulge me in that regard. Turmeric has over 1,000 potential medicinal components, and there are thousands of studies, which you can find in PubMed.gov, which support turmeric doing certain things in beneficial things in health. But what does that mean if you have Alzheimer's or brain fog or cognitive decline, or you're worried about it, or you're a caregiver or your physician? Well, I made this video for caregivers, medical personnel, because I think it's a little, maybe a little complicated for someone who's moderately in cognitive decline. So hopefully this will reach you through your caregivers. In any event, if you have any questions, please sit down and look at this with your healthcare provider or your caregiver. So, exciting news is that out of Presbyterian Hospital, the medical director of the Alzheimer's Prevention Clinic, did you get that? The Alzheimer's Prevention Clinic said there's convincing evidence for the use of curcumin in Alzheimer's conditions. And he cites a study, and he cites what form of curcumin they used. Well, the curcumin is a nanoparticle, and it's called theracumin, T-H-E-R-A-C-U-M-I-N. And it's a brand name, trademarked, and you can get it on Amazon from a variety of products or brands with a variety of prices. Now, as Dr. Isaacson, the author of the video, says, this nanoparticles in theracumin cross the get into the bloodstream. Now, that's the problem with turmeric curcumin up to date. It hasn't been absorbed. Now, you could take the theracumin, but Dr. Isaacson doesn't commit to that. He tries, or says he uses off-the-shelf turmeric as a spice in your food. And that's not, I think, the best way to go, in my opinion, because you have absorption issues, as implied by the study, which used nanoparticles. So, what I use is Dr. Sears' curcumin triple burn, and that, if you're familiar with my other videos, I am a proponent of Dr. Sears because he's in clinical practice, and that's a good deal if someone's in clinical practice and they're using it because they have the feedback, the common sense, the feedback, the observation Dr. Isaacson is going from study to study, but we have to wait for the next study. Dr. Sears is already implementing it in practice. It's called Curcumin Triple Burn. There is a link to the product in Dr. Sears' product in the description below, along with a link to Dr. Isaacson's video. It's 3 minutes long. I think it's worthwhile reading. And what is my recommendation? I think you should be on turmeric curcumin. You can take what I am taking, which is curcumin triple burn, or you can do one of the theracumin alternatives. And please subscribe to my channel as more videos are coming. Turmeric seems to be safe. Dr. Isaacson states that he doesn't know if it's worth it can prevent, but it does seem to work well in treatment.